But after baby say, what you do, next batch also same thing they will do. So instability, they have put some other sensor. Oh, we have done IoT. IoT, I said, like, you know, 1961 it started. Internet started in 1961. Now people talk about Internet of Everything. But they forgot IoT. Yes, the IoT is a very small act. So Internet of Everything meaning, like, you know, whatever you want to do, communicate, can be captured and sent. That's called IoE or Internet of Everything. But let us first understand what is IoT, right? Internet of Things. First they come to Internet of Devices. I talk about some devices. Then we talk about the things. The things here is normally the data. The data or the things. The things come from the data, use the data and communicate through wireless to the cloud or through the internet and then store, act and do something. So that's why the Internet of Things is going to grow, because you have plenty of data from the devices. Devices you can able to transmit, store it, analyze it, then we call it big data. Data only simply they give a name called big data. They told cloud because cloud stores water, plenty of water. So the Americans are very good at actually naming, you know. So they told cloud management. Cloud was there, you know, time memorial, with plenty of water, correct? Especially Bangalore rainy season, you can see how cloud is going to act. Right? You can't walk, so much water comes. It was stored, right? The water was stored in the cloud. So similarly, the data is being stored in the cloud, so they call it cloud. Internet is stored, like, you know, it is a communication. So there are so many protocols. So many protocols you can do, manipulate. I don't know how many of you understand IPv4 and IPv6, because IPv4 was being used to have your IP address of 32 bit. When you want to have a 32-bit IP address, because when so many youngsters, millions and millions of people want to use with a unique ID, it has got crowded. So now people go in for IPv6. Please note down, IPv6 is going to be the thing when you want to work on software algorithms. IPv4 is gone, and you are going for where you can have with an address up to 128 bits. That means maybe for next 10, 15 years, you can able to manage, maybe beyond that you have to see something is going to happen. So I will quickly touch upon, I'm not going to talk about the protocols, I'm not talking about actually how the IoT is going to be done. Anyway, in the afternoon, when you have the lab, I think our youngsters from Nikon, they're going to teach you, they're going to demonstrate to you. I've been working with them the last 5 years, and I see these boys trying to build an IoT platform for simple applications like agriculture, maybe for some other application. You can learn something practical from them. So I will only prelude saying that how the Internet of Things, Internet of Everything, is going to make things more smarter. One is actually smart sensors, the next is called smart communication. So the communication portion, I will say, you know the most of the things, nothing so not known to you. I'm only exposing you so that you'll get a feel. You get a feel saying these are the opportunities coming up maybe for down, say, 13 years. Some of them are actually future products, but everybody is trying to get that market. I think everybody knows about the Google car, right? No? Autonomous car? Driverless car? Is it possible to drive in MG Road in Bangalore? Or MG Road in Bangalore? Or Whitefield in Bangalore? When you have 5,000 vehicles are crowded, a stretch of 1 kilometer, what do you do with the autonomous car? Like my car, I can drive at 120 to 130 kilometers in a highway, but Bangalore, my average speed is 10 to 15 kilometers. I'm not joking. So we should see the relevance of technology where it can be deployed. One more thing I am seeing, this IoT is going to have great wars and kill people instantly. You put a bomb, big bomb, somebody like say 100 kg in an autonomous car, a big crowd in a Bangalore city, big function is going on, so you can just park the car and put a timer and trigger it. Gone now, some 1,000 people will instantly go. Every day is happening in Syria. I know how many of you know. They use the drones with a specific target. Program it from your tablet, hit it with a point of 5 cm accuracy. Imagine. So you put a bomb, 5 cm, maybe like 100 meters radius, it gets killed. Every day it's happening. So technology is for the progress, technology is for the destruction. So we should not get into the destruction, but if we like it or not, it goes to the wrong hands. No? It happens. So IoT may look very fancy. I may to look very progressive, interesting. My gut feeling is it is also going to give enough harm. Like I see the students, they use WhatsApp up to 1 o'clock night. Next day morning, 9 o'clock, they can't attend the class. Okay, you sleep at 2 o'clock. Right? When you sleep at 2 o'clock, how can you come at 9 o'clock? With great difficulty with your mom scolding you, you come to the class. I've been to some hostels, and at 12 o'clock I go, the boys are seeing video at 12 o'clock. So next day morning when they come, you know, their eyes are red. So this has got a negative effect. So it has been used with sort of a purpose. They used sort of a requirement. Fine, everything. When you have limits, right, you enjoy. When you cross the limits, either you become a diabetic patient or you become some other patient, or you become an addict. So I strongly feel that internet or IoT is interesting. It has got a lot of applications which I am going to show you, but it has also got some negative effects, but let us carry forward. Okay? So if you look at this IoT or internet, 2003, just a small portion of it is connected. By 2020, we are talking 50 billion devices are going to be connected. Imagine. India's population is something like 120 billion. It's not the people. It is the number of devices going to be connected to the people. So we've got a very high growth rate in the IoT for application. So far, I think whatever I'm talking is mainly meant for the physical layer. Because I want you to understand the physical layer, which is the sensing and control. Sensing and gathering information. That is the first step. The second one is called the wireless technology. Like I have a wireless mouse, I'm just communicating to my laptop. How do I do? There is a small wireless chip set there. There is also a small wireless protocol written there. So when I just interact, when I try to interact, wirelessly I'm able to send the commands. So this is the network layer. So when you want to do the data processing, like our brain, that is the third layer. The end of it, I just want to have an application. Like say, the New Delhi, Karol Bagh, street number 23, door number 150, I want to switch on my geyser. Is it possible? It is perfectly possible. So I just use the Google Map, I go to the 23 street in Karol Bagh, I see the door number, I'll just press. My command goes through the internet, goes to the cloud, comes back, and goes to their internet, and goes to their server, or maybe the device, it gets activated. So this is the power of IoT for an application. It's going to happen. So you need to understand these four layers. These four layers, how it's going to work. Okay? So you can see people connecting with things, like where you can see different parts of our body can be get connected through the internet. So this is one of the applications where I just showed you something back as a live picture. So this is a live application. Then we talked about the automobile, where it's, you know, you get connected through the wireless, and you can also get connected cars. This is going to happen. Okay. So I've been talking this smart home with the last, say, 5 years. But still our homes are not smart, but some portion of our homes are smart. So maybe LED TV, which is remotely controlling, or maybe some other appliances what we have can be smartly controlled. So like it or not, maybe like, you know, down say 5 years, we're going to have a lot of homes which are having more number of sensors. So we call it maybe smart home, because everything we call it now smart. Sometimes dumb also, we can, okay, so we use the word smart without knowing the value of smart. So it's happening. So a lot of marketing is taking place where in smart home based applications, where you have a geyser getting activated, a room AC getting activated, like I don't know how many of you have seen Amitabh Bachchan just triggering Volta's AC sitting at one place and then saying that, no, you see your uncle's place, I'm getting switched on. So these are, you know, it's happening. You like it or it's happening. So the smart home will come up in a big way, because people become more lazy, they don't want to walk, they don't want to run, so they just want to sit in a cell phone and trigger. Correct? Either their own home or somewhere else, but I think their own home they want to stop, because sometime back, TV, I think morning, they were attacking on chief guest, then get one channel, 1984, because I started buying my TV in 1982, Asian Games. So I waited for 5 years to buy a TV, because I thought, like, you know, I get a better TV. So I bought actually imported TV, color TV itself, instead of black and white. So this technology, when you sometimes wait, you get a better options. Like, you know, cell phone, people talk about, like, you know, Apple 7, 8, 9, now they have 10. In business, it's called opportunity cost. I had an Apple 4S, I bought, so somebody gifted me 5 years back. I just went to the market, what is the value? They told me 1,000 rupees. I bought it for 40,000 rupees. It was so dear. So you see the technology option today. So the smart homes is going to be like, you know, next thing. No, I got a smart home. So their price goes up. Because people like kids, they like it, you know, I want, like, you know, with all the wireless, all what fancy thing required. So dad also, like, it doesn't matter, okay, we'll buy that house. It's going to happen in Bangalore. You like it or not, shortly. So these are the things I think happening in the IoT domain. Next is a very simple, interesting, like, egg tray. You keep it there. Sometimes, you know, you forget, actually, you got the egg tray in your fridge. These sensors actually, the health of the egg, and telling, no, you have to throw it. Okay, you forgot to take it out. Okay, fridge is having so much things, right? Sometimes, you know, you forgot to take certain things out. So the sensor is going to be used to remind you, saying that, now this egg kept in serial number 4 is not usable. So this is going to give an alert. This is going to give an alert. Okay? Washing machine, I think, going to be a lot of automation going to take place, because that's why I think, you know, people are all lying. How to use the, you put your washing machine, close everything, you put it. Maybe around, say, 11 o'clock or 12 o'clock, you switch on when you're in the office. Okay, it takes around 2.5 hours, because they don't want to keep the clothes inside. So when I come over at 4:30, 5 o'clock, it has washed the clothes. So now you can take it out, because, you know, in US and all, you don't get servants. And how many of you know? Even if you're earning something like $10,000 per month, you don't get servants. On the weekends, you have to wash your clothes yourself. You have to swap your house. So the necessity is the mother of invention in US, not in India. So we follow simply American technology, like it or not. No, America is doing it, so we'll also do it. So there's no options. So I think, you know, it's going to happen here also, because with 10 lakh people in Bangalore with IT background, so nothing I can say. That's for CNRO. Anybody, how many of you know CNRO? So many people know. You know, he's a hardcore chemist, correct? Throughout, he's 85. So he written so many technologies on chemistry. So he calls IT people as a coolie fellows. Openly. because it's very difficult to digest, but there's no options because he's a great scientist. And he has seen the life. Okay, so the washing machines are going to listen to our cell phone and do the needful the days to come. Smart lighting, already a lot of work is happening abroad. I think our Prime Minister Modi has introduced called smart city concept. Around 1 lakh crores is going to spend maybe next 7-8 years. I think in Karnataka, I think there are 4 cities that have become likely to become smart. Likely, I told you the word is likely because we really don't know like what smart is going to happen with all that our so-and-so politics is collecting the data for other purposes. So the smart lighting is useful, especially in the highways, when you are trying to control the light and save the power. It's a beautiful tool. I think it's been used extensively in Barcelona Olympics some 4 years back. And this smart lighting is going to come in a big way. Like Bajaj, you know, how many of you know Bajaj? Bajaj is actually doing a lot of work on smart city. Crompton, L&T, VEL, and Cisco, all these guys are doing a lot of work on smart cities. Somebody really work on smart cities until you get a job. You work on smart city based algorithms, smart city based sensors, smart city based hardware, you'll be recognized because a lot of job opportunities. Same Infosys is going to change their portfolio because they're also looking at it. Infosys, Wipro, Cognizant, all of them actually looking at smart city as a next growth for their IP activity. Okay, so I will take maybe another say 3 minutes because I know like 1:30 you all told me. So you can set alarms on your cell phones and then you can also see how much snoring you are doing. All the data can be actually collected during the sleeping time. Similarly, smart weather, I think all of you are getting weather reports when you, before landing Delhi, what is the temperature before landing in Bangalore, I can see there's cloudy or all the data can be done with a cloud-based technology. Then smart cooker, I think already come. It is going to be much more smarter in the days to come because we want to trigger the cooker just before coming home so that you know your rice is ready or maybe some other dal is ready so that you can have the dinner the moment you reach home. It's all going to happen. Smart garbage, I think everybody talks about garbage. Smart garbage, I don't know, really going to work in India? I really doubtful, but anyway, people talking, so many students do projects, no sir, I made a smart garbage. Everybody puts the dust outside and how the garbage is going to fill up? No? They leave and throw it out rather than putting it in the dustbin. So this is the reality. So we are trying to simply follow certain rules, but I think we have to modify it to suit our conditions. Okay, smart garden, I think we discussed something like that. IoT applications in the transport, I think it is going to be a big activity because like, you know, transport, I think anybody seen Bangalore Metro, how many transport Bangalore Metro? It is the best in the world, I'm telling you. It has got plenty of sensors, it has got wireless, so many technology being incubated so that it is going to be more and more smart. I think the transport is going to get benefited by the IoT applications. Okay? BMTC gets smart kicks off the bus ticketing, so they have done a lot of IoT applications. So, yeah. So, if you look at, as I said, I'm leaving the slides. Please have a look at the spectrum of IoT applications. It's mind-boggling. So you take only one small problem in our electronics, see whether you can set up a lab with NCS and maybe your professors. The opportunities are plenty. It all depends upon how you want to be, where you want to be, how you want to be. So, satellites, you're talking about the nano satellites, which is going to be IoT connected. Satellite communication is going to be in the future based on Internet of Things. Because a lot of small satellites are going to be launched and it gives you a lot of a confidence to the communication community. Okay, there are technologies which is all coming up. Some of them are already used, like Bluetooth. All of you know that you're using a Bluetooth speaker. So it's again IoT enabled. Zigbee again IoT enabled. There are new technologies coming up. I think this, 3 years back, I started understanding my own team. Some 3 projects I given on LoRa. LoRa meaning long range wireless. So it can go up to 20 kilometers. So this is a beautiful technology coming up. SigFox. I think all of you know about 3G, right? Your phones are 3G enabled. Now the Reliance came 4G LTE. What is the difference between 3G and 4G LTE? You can go in for? Going for what? Video chat. But how they're cheating so bluntly. 10% of the 4G LTE has been used in India. Because they don't want to invest money, but they want to take more money. So millions of students have just subscribed to 4G LTE, but you don't get the benefit because they're connected so less and they don't want to invest, they want pocket plus profit. All the service providers first take their money out. Then they see how the technology can be given. So 4G LTE is a good technology, but I think now people talk about 5G. I think maybe down, say, 5 years, we're going to 5G. But 4G itself, we are not able to use because all the telecom providers are just giving a lip service. Okay, that's what I told you, like, you know, these are going to come. Okay, why some of them I told is not implementing in India? Because we are a democratic country, correct? Anybody can go to court, anybody can put litigation, anybody can stop certain technologies. So the regulation is becoming, because it is used for the good, it is used for the bad. So you have to be careful about the regulation and the purchasing, because technology when you want to do incubate, I told you about the 4G LTE. They are not able to put it across because they want to have an instant growth. But I know because I've been talking to them for the last, say, 5 years, and they're able to so beautifully mesmerize the youngsters giving freebies. 6 months, you know, they all give free internet, unlimited data. So everybody thought, okay, now we are going to get robbed. But then he started with 100 rupees, 300, 400. I think today, I think minimum is 400 rupees. So this is going to be, business is going to be there, but at the same time, you can able to enjoy the technology. So what I could see, like, I said I have more slides, but I'll leave it here. So it was good for me to come and spend some time with all of you, even though I was a little hectic activity when I'm doing, you know, one day for me is also one day lost. But I thought maybe I'll come and maybe spend some time with young students and see how this technology, sensors and IoT, can be triggered for a constructive purpose. So I think you start a lab, you start some activities, I'm sure, I think, you know, with IBM Watson, because IBM Watson is a pretty good group and they have a lot of technologies. I don't know what extent they're going to give it to you, but I think at least you can say, like, IBM Watson certified, something like a color up type. So I think there's going to be an opportunity for all of you to work with IBM Watson and Nikon and then make the software upgrade, but sensor upgrade they will not give you. You need to work on yourself and upgrade yourself and then see that you get placed in the coming days. So I thank your chairman, electronics from Mangalore University, Mr. Naveen, and Nikon, Umesh, and your vice chancellor for giving me the opportunity to come and talk to you and share some of the views on smart sensors and IoT. Thank you.
So I think all have enjoyed the talk that was given by the sir. It was really informative. So I'm here before you to thank Dr. K. Natarajan for delivering the brief lecture and briefing about the future aspects of IoT. Thank you, sir. I request Professor Naveen Kumar SK, Chairman of Electronics Department, to give a token of love. We also have Mr. Ravindra, partner of Vision Tech, with us as a support for this workshop. Also, he has given us has put out a demonstrative stall out the auditorium. So we thank you, sir. So we ask Dr. K. Natarajan to give a memento to Mr. Ravindra as a token of love. Thank you, sir.
ಚಿಲಿಪಿಲಿ ಗುಟ್ಟುತ್ತಿರುವಂತಹ ಹಕ್ಕಿಗಳು ಚಿಲಿಪಿಲಿ ಗುಟ್ಟುತ್ತಿರುವಂತಹ ಹಕ್ಕಿಗಳು ತಮ್ಮ ತಮ್ಮ ಗೂಡು ಸೇರ್ತಾ ಇರತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಸಂದರ್ಭದಲ್ಲಿ ಹಾಗೆ ಹಾಲು ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತಕ್ಕಂತಹ ನಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರ ಗೋಮಾತೆ ಹಾಲು ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ನಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರ ಗೋಮಾತೆ ತಮ್ಮ ತಮ್ಮ ಹಟ್ಟಿಗಳಿಗೆ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಗೋಧೂಳಿ ಮುಹೂರ್ತದಲ್ಲಿ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಅಲ್ಲ ಕ್ರೀಡಾ ಅಭಿಮಾನಿಗಳು ಇವತ್ತು ಬೆಂಗಳೂರು ಮುಂಬೈ ಮ್ಯಾಚ್ ಇದೆ ಅದಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ಅದೆಷ್ಟೋ ಜನ ಕಾತರದಿಂದ ಕಾಯ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ ಅದೆಲ್ಲದರ ಮಧ್ಯದಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವಿಲ್ಲಿ ಸೇರಿದ್ದೀವಿ ಮಂಗಳೂರು ವಿಶ್ವವಿದ್ಯಾನಿಲಯದ ಮಂಗಳ ಸಭಾಂಗಣದಲ್ಲಿ ಹೌದು ಸ್ನೇಹಿತರೆ ಮಂಗಳೂರು ವಿಶ್ವವಿದ್ಯಾಲಯದ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನಿಕ್ಸ್ ವಿಭಾಗದ ವತಿಯಿಂದ ನಡೀತಾ ಇರ್ತಕ್ಕಂತಹ ರಾಷ್ಟ್ರೀಯ ಕಾರ್ಯಾಗಾರದ ಪ್ರಯುಕ್ತ ಇವತ್ತು ಸಾಂಸ್ಕೃತಿಕ ರಸಸಂಜೆ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮವನ್ನು ಹಮ್ಮಿಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೇವೆ ಅದಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ಬಂದಿರತಕ್ಕಂಥ ತಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಮತ್ತೊಮ್ಮೆ ಸ್ವಾಗತಿಸುತ್ತಾ ನಾನು ಕೆ ಎನ್ ಹರೀಶ್ ನಮ್ಮ ಜೊತೆಗಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಪ್ರಿಯಾಂಕಾ ಭಟ್
ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದಲ್ಲಿ ಸೇರಿರುವ ಎಲ್ಲ ಗೌರವಾನ್ವಿತ ಅತಿಥಿಗಳಿಗೆ ಹಾಗೂ ಪ್ರಾಧ್ಯಾಪಕರಿಗೆ ಮಿತ್ರರಿಗೆ ಹಾಗೂ ಎಲ್ಲ ಗಣ್ಯರಿಗೆ ಶುಭ ಸಂಜೆಯ ಶುಭ ನಮನಗಳನ್ನ ತಿಳಿಸುತ್ತಾ ಈ ಒಂದು ಸಾಂಸ್ಕೃತಿಕ ರಸಸಂಜೆ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮಕ್ಕೆ ಮತ್ತೊಮ್ಮೆ ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಸ್ವಾಗತವನ್ನ ಕೋರ್ತೇನೆ ಈ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದ ನಿರೂಪಕಿಯಾಗಿ ನಿಮ್ ಜೊತೆ ನಾನಿರ್ತೇನೆ ಪ್ರಿಯಾಂಕಾ
ಇವತ್ತು ಈ ವೇದಿಕೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಸಾಂಸ್ಕೃತಿಕ ಲೋಕದ ಅನಾವರಣ ನಡಲಿಕ್ಕಿದೆ ಡಾನ್ಸು ಹಾಸ್ಯ ಮ್ಯಾಜಿಕ್ ಶೋ ಎಲ್ಲವರೂ ಈ ಒಂದು ವೇದಿಕೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ನಡಲಿಕ್ಕಿದೆ ತಾವೆಲ್ಲರೂ ಜೋರಾದ ಚಪ್ಪಾಳೆಯ ಮೂಲಕ ಈ ಒಂದು ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮಕ್ಕೆ ಚಾಲನೆಗೊಳಿಸಬೇಕಾಗಿ ತಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಕೇಳಿಕೊಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇನೆ
ಈ ಒಂದು ಸಾಂಸ್ಕೃತಿಕ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮಕ್ಕೆ ಒಂದು ಪರಿಪೂರ್ಣ ಅರ್ಥವನ್ನ ಕೊಡಲು ಭಕ್ತಿಯಿಂದ ಶಂಕರನನ್ನ ಸ್ಮರಿಸಲು ಭಕ್ತಿಗೀತೆಯೊಂದಿಗೆ ಇದೀಗ ವೇದಿಕೆಗೆ ಆಗಮಿಸಲಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಶ್ರೀ ಪ್ರಸನ್ನ ಕಡಬ
ನಾದ ಶರೀರ ಪರ ವೇದ ವಿಹಾರ ಹರ ಜೀವೇಶ್ವರ ಯೋಗಮಾನಿ ನಾದೋಪಾಸನ ಚೇಸಿನ ವಾಡನು ನೀವಾ ನವೀನ ನಿನ್ನಿತ್ರ ಗಾನವಿ ಆಧರಿಂಚರಿಂಚನ ಶಂಕರ ನಾದ ಶರೀರ ಬರ ವೇದ ವಿಹಾರ ಜೀವೇಶ್ವರ
ಕಥೆ ಕಂಡ
ಖುಷಿಯಾಗುವಿತು. ಬರಗಾಲದಲ್ಲಿ ಸುರಿ ಸುರಿದಂಗಾಯ್ತು.
ನಮಸ್ತೆ, ಆದಾಬ್, ಸತ್ ಶ್ರೀ ಅಕಾಲ್, ವಣಕ್ಕಂ. ಮ್ಯಾಜಿಕ್ ಇಸ್ ಅನ್ ಆರ್ಟ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ಯೂರ್ಲಿ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಸೈನ್ಸ್. ಡು ಯು ಅಗ್ರಿ ವಿತ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆರ್ ನೋ? ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಎನಿ ಮಂತ್ರ ತಂತ್ರ? ನೋ, ಮ್ಯಾಜಿಕ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಪ್ಯೂರ್ ಸೈಂಟಿಫಿಕ್ ಆರ್ಟ್. ವಾಟ್ ಐ ಮೀನ್ ಟು ಸೇ ಇಸ್, ಸೊ ಒನ್ಸ್ ದ ಮ್ಯಾಜಿಕ್ ಇಸ್ ಡನ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್, ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಮ್ಯಾಜಿಕ್? ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಎಂಟರ್ಟೈನ್ಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ, ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ surprised also, right? So today I am going to perform one of such magic, and also a magic is one, there are some items which are very risky and dangerous also. Today in front of you, with all your cooperation and support, I'll perform one of such risky magic show. So for this, thank you. For this I need two audience on the stage, one from the ladies and one from the gents. Please, first, one from the ladies and one from the gents, please. So first, please come, please, any one from the gents and any one from the ladies. Any one from ladies, please come, ma'am. Please come, please come, please come, please come. So here we have, what's your name? Pratik. Pratik with us, and Rashmi with us. Rashmi ma'am and Pratik. So please, this time. So you are the representatives of all these audience. Give a big applause to them. Thanks for coming. So now I have some stuffs here. So what you have to do is you have to check it properly. Is that okay? Music please. Slow. Volume down. Volume less. Please ready. Okay. So there are locks, right? One lock I'll give to you and also to ma'am. Okay? Please check that lock. Press it. Is it locked? Now is it possible to open that lock? Madam, please try. Not possible?
No.
Okay, fine. So there are some keys. With this you can open. Okay, these are the keys which is used to open the lock. Is that okay? You open it. Okay, let her open. You check this. I have one more big lock which can also be tested, which will be locked by the key. There is a key. Is that open? Okay, you please check now. Okay, open, right? Okay, one more lock is there, no? Please check it, ma'am. Open it. Open that lock. So now this lock is open. What they are telling is it cannot be opened without the key. Is it right? Okay, fine. Okay, they are testing. Please give time to them. Okay, is it open, right? Madam, you have one more lock, no? Please test it, this also. Please check here, no other locks are there, right? Fine? Okay. Whether locks are proper? Yes, it is locking with the key and it will not be opened without key. Is it right? Same keys also. Okay? All the keys I will hand over to you. No need to check every key. The key will be with you. Okay, no need to worry. Okay, I have one more stuff here. Please give it back. Keep it here. So I have one more stuff here. Can you identify what it is? It is called as poda, right? Handcuff, right? So please check this also. I have one more chain here. Check for this, whether any breakage is there in this. Is there any breakage in this, or is it possible to cut it, or any opening in that? Because you have to check it properly, because audience will believe on you only, not on me. Nobody will believe magicians. Is it right?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. Fine. So this is checked, right? And also this one is checked. All the stuffs are checked. Just a minute. I invite Jocelyn here to continue with this, right? Please hold the mic.
So we have a bag here. So the ones who are standing can check for any openings, zip, cuts, all through the back. See if there is any hole or zip or any other opening so that you can try to open. Go fully inside. Anything? Can you see? No? Okay. Check for the rope too. If the rope is flexible, breakable, just check it. So do we have any breakages or any? So it seems there are no holes, breakages, zip, any openings and all that. Even the rope is flexible, not breakable, and it's tight. So first she'll be handcuffed. With lock, which can be opened only by keys. So the person standing is trying to handcuff her with the lock. So only keys needed to open it. many knots. I think that will be sufficient for her not to escape. And now the rope is tied with the chain. Again, there's a helix shaped chain. And there's a big lock. Know that you have seen that she's perfectly locked. She goes inside. And now she comes out of the box and of the bag, removing all the chains.
Thank you. Bye. जीना तेरे